So in the new versions of Pages, Numbers, and Keynote that came out last week, there's a new feature to be found inside of Preferences. So if I go here to Pages Preferences, you can see that in addition to General and Rules, there's now Auto Correction. And this shows some options here for some things that may look familiar, because we've had these in different places before and we've had some of this stuff system-wide. But now we have settings that are specific to these apps. And they only work for each app. So you can have a different set of settings here for Pages and another set for Numbers, for instance. So anything you set here is just for Pages, and it works across all Pages documents. So you open a new one or edit an old one and these settings will stay. So what we've got here are things of whether or not spelling is going to be checked automatically, formatting, things like smart quotes, you know, when you type quotes on your keyboard, whether they're, you know, curly to the left or curly to the right and how they are. You can turn these on or off specifically for Pages in this case. Also, text replacement. So we have the system wide, but here's a set that's only for Pages, for instance. So I can add one here. I'm probably going to be typing the phrase macOS High Sierra a lot. So I can say MHS converts to macOS High Sierra. And now when I type, I can type MHS. And you see, as soon as I hit spacebar return, it does the substitution for me. And this doesn't add it to System Preferences, where it would work everywhere, but it only adds it inside of Numbers. Now, you may remember there are other ways to get to these. In the past, you were able to see these if you went to Edit, and then you went to things like, say, Substitutions, and there's Smart Quotes and Smart Dashes. So I could actually change these here. If I turn off Smart Quotes, you can see it gives me a dash here, because in this control area, Smart Quotes and dashes are in the same place. But in here, they're separate. So if I turn off Smart Dashes, you can see it turns it off completely there. If I were to go to, say, Links, I turn that off, you can see it turns it off here. So you do have the ability to control it in both places still, but this is just a place where you can go to it. You also have ignored words. So you can go in here and see words that are to be ignored by the spell checker. So I could just simply, you know, let's just type a bunch of random characters and you can see it spell checks that. I could control click on it and say ignore spelling. Now if I go into Preferences, Autocorrection, Ignored Words, you can see it's listed there. I can select it and delete it. So there are definitely some idiosyncrasies here. You know, notice in spelling and grammar here, check spelling while typing and correct grammar with spelling, correct spelling automatically. Doesn't quite match up to these here, so it can get confusing at times which one's turned on. Also under substitutions, you've got this So Substitutions panel here, which kind of conflicts with some of the stuff that you see up there as well. You know, you can decide where you want to set things and just keep in mind that it doesn't always match up with some of these menus. But in general, it works pretty well and it's nice to have this all here. And it's really nice to have these settings, especially text replacement, specific to Pages where people do a lot of writing and may want to have replacements that don't actually apply anywhere else on the Mac.